Hello, good afternoon everyone. I'm Shikha Ajit, Senior Architect at InnerSpace Interiors. So I'm here to take you through one of our most prestigious projects that we've worked upon. And we had designed and delivered it around 1 or 2 years ago. And through this experience, I would like to explain what customer journey means to us and how we take care of our customers. This code, separating the signal from the noise. This explains as professionals in the field, especially if you're a designer, what is your role and responsibility in listening to your clients. We have to sit down with them, we listen to them, we listen to so many different partners, stakeholders, all associated to the project. And it is part of the architecture program, or the design program, to listen to all these kind of stakeholders. Be it the designers, the partners, the consultants, the clients, stakeholders, and the most important, the users who are actually going to be there in the space that we designed for them. And and we derive from these criteria, those specific criteria which lead to the design of the space we build. If we take this line, which is an endless loop to be as part of a project. It involves a lot of milestones which are where a lot of topics are discussed, debated, approved with the customer. So we have to sit down with them, understand what it is, plan these milestones ahead of time, and this helps us to push the project forward. So the project I was talking about is Arabian Radio Network, ARN. ARN is a high performance office cum broadcasting studios. It has two counterparts. The office part, which holds 200 to 250 numbers of employees, along with a lot of common amenities like dining spaces or breakout and waiting lounges and the whole office package. And then there is the broadcasting studios, which is actually a very niche industry and is quite challenging because it comes with its own challenges which we don't deal on a daily basis. For a project like ARN, which takes around such a huge number of employees in the consideration, and the fact that they're moving into a new office which is 38,000 square feet area, we propose that we go with a very agile methodology of working with them so that we take the whole span of the project, break it down to sprints, and each sprint we will sit down with the customer and try to understand what their dreams, wishes are that they want to implement in their new office. And this we were able to do. And as a cherry on top, we actually had a facilitator, so I'm going to call him the single point of contact, Mr. Spock, referencing from Star Trek. And he was there with us throughout the journey of this project, right from the first sketch till all the way to the design and build. So he would sit down with us in our office or any other venue that demanded, and we would resolve the issues together, even starting from the initial zoning. So the two colors that are shown on this sketch are the two zones. And the space plan is for a level. This is the level, which is the 38,000 square feet, and there is a smaller wing to it on another floor. And it was one of the challenges that we had to face at ARA was how the path, the movement, or the circulation was going to be treated. So we have the visitors and we have the employees, and both come in large numbers because it's a broadcasting studios, and the visitors who are coming here involve a lot of VIPs, VVIPs, dignitaries who need a very secure path to go in and to get in and get out quickly. So what you see here in the blue dots, this is where the staff are more concentrated. A lot of employees have all their amenities in these zones. While let's say the C zone is where the studios were located, and the VIPs were entertained in this zone alone. What you see in yellow dots, these are those notes which became important stopping points where there was something interesting or wow which gave a wholesome experience and binded together the complete the design of the space. So a quick glimpse to all the initial schematics analysis that we sat down with our customer, whether all their questions, how is the daylight coming, how is the sun path, how is, what is the materials, textures, color, concept, all these questions, these are the milestones that I was speaking about. There is the other side to it where the execution also comes, which is a much more bigger platform. Here, I would like to show how in the beginning we propose a 3D perspective or a 3D view of what the customer wishes, and then when it comes to a final design, there are a lot of decisions and a lot of stakeholders who put conclusion on these designs, and it transforms. As professionals, it becomes our responsibility to make sure this change is for the better and to control and give them something better than what we had proposed in the beginning. I also like to show you. Love the design that we have done for ARN. I love it. So, but this was not easy. It came with its own package of challenges which we had to face, and along with our customer, we sat down with them. They also participated, the teams, the most skilled engineers from our customer's team also participated to resolve a lot of issues, especially those revolving acoustics. Because knowing that it's a studio, it had a lot of high acoustic treatment that had to be given. And we did do the traditional, like the conventional treatment on the ceiling, on the floor, on the walls with the absorbers, diffusers, cut out the sound completely. Then we had to take it one step further, where we have a room within another room concept. Now this completely cuts out any vibrations or sound leakage into or out of the room. So this was made possible by having this box in a box theme concept that completely cut out these kind of vibrations, and even the glass or the walls were layered to multiple levels, had thicker walls around 250 to 400 centimeters thick, and it resulted in a great solution. If you see, these are the 9 main broadcasting studios of ARN, and you can see there is glass all around. There is 2 types of glass here. One is the exterior and one is the interior. The interior glass partitions, like I mentioned, has layers which tackles the sound reflection. The exterior glass comes with its own challenges because it has the noise from the street. It has a high heat intensity which we needed to concern. Taking all these things into consideration, we were still able to give them maximum glass, because this was a very, very important request from our clients, that they wanted a seamless connection among people. People had to be connected, the RJs had to be connected to their teams and to the VIPs who come, and this we were able to achieve. The central media server, this is basically the data servers of all the broadcasting studios. So any data is routed through the servers, and this became a point which also emits a lot of heat and noise. However, we did not just put the server into a room and lock it. What we did is we kept it right in the middle where everybody can see, and put a lot of glass around it and made it the most interesting and iconic space in the studio area. So you can see all the pop of colors also which we did to adorn the space is actually the colors from the logo of the 12 broadcasting stations that AR represents. The zoning also, these are the common amenities which were strategically placed in those nodes where the vertical circulation of the building happens. So we had 8 lifts distributed 4-4 on either ends of the level, and we were able to give huge waiting spaces and breakout where the whole team can come together and have a very efficient work environment. There's also a big multimedia production house which ARN has, and this was also strategically located in the ground floor. As they had a lot of equipments that used to come in and out on a daily basis, and yet in spite of being separate and far, the design was kept seamless and continuous throughout these levels. We have also introduced a street theme into the interiors of the space. This is because we keep in mind that ARN is an organization which caters to at least more than 200 nationalities across Dubai. And even within the organization, we have so many different cultures, and it is good to bring a theme which doesn't hold any roots in place, and we could go as interesting as possible. And this is a very nice image which shows how we have used glass to connect people. You have the studios on the right hand side, and you have the workstations or the waiting lounges on the left hand side. And they are very well connected. They can wave at each other from one to the other space. And then we make it a little more interesting by adding a running track in the middle to make them feel more connected to the outside, which was what they wanted. I would like to show you how our customers took it from there.
So what are we doing on the show today?
No, that's at 7. No, that's going to be.
Well, let's do it now. Do that at 8:20 though as well.
Okay. No, that's. Guys, come on. What are you doing? Guys, seriously, we're not doing this again. We are not doing this again.
3, 2, 1.
Across the country, morning!
Office.